All right, a couple announcements to make. We are currently about $300 off from the shirtless Caleb Hart, but if that is met during the run, Caleb will take off his shirt in rather manly fashion. A couple of more announcements. Prizes for games since we went down, which was about 7 a.m., will be extended to 7 p.m. Eastern Time tonight. In addition, a very interesting donation incentive to have Simon Vicklins, the composer for Bionic Commando Rearmed, do a remixed soundtrack of one of the NES games that is played during this marathon is being extended until noon tomorrow. Now, you all just saw a bunch of awesome NES soundtracks from Bucky O'Hare to Kid Icarus to Journey to Silius. Any of those games and any other NES game that is being played during this marathon is eligible for a remix. So make sure to get your money in by noon tomorrow. And one of the prizes being extended until 7 p.m. tonight is a genuine Nintendo Entertainment System boxed, worth quite a bit of money now. As you can see, it is an action set back in the day when they were trying to advertise it as a toy. Because of the whole Atari crash thing. A little history for you. But if you donate during this game, at least $25, you have the chance of winning this lovely Mega Man X Perler made by our own Mecha Richter. It is quite sizable and a lot of love was put into it.
You want me to tell them beforehand that there's money on the line here? Okay, and then I'll read it.
So again, the box NES with Zapper is a buy-in of $20. Thank you very much to Retro Gamer Ryan for giving that to us as a prize. Just a reminder, we are Speed Demos Archive. We are a website that runs games very, very quickly and posts high-quality videos online. We also have a forum and knowledge base. In addition, we have many people here from speedrunslive.com, your premier source for races of all your favorite games. And we are currently running a charity marathon for the Prevent Cancer Foundation, whose mission statement is research, education, and outreach for the prevention of cancer. Okay. Well, it's looking like Caleb is not going to have to worry about doing this mid-run because that was met surprisingly quickly. Well, not even surprisingly quickly. What am I talking about? Well, Caleb, it's going shirtless. Thank you very much, Bruce White, for your $100 donation. Hey, Caleb, I did it. Weigh in on the scale at work this morning before I left was 286 exactly. The 50 pounds hype was real. $2 per pound as promised. $100 goes to you getting that shirt popped off for your run. Can't wait for our shirtless flex session and chest bump next year. Sub 36 hype and good luck. Thank you very much, Dark CEO, for the $10 donation. Here's another donation. Good luck to my bros Caleb Hart and Z-Wing. Sad I couldn't make the AGDQ, but hey, there is a next time. Again, I wanted to give a very special thank you for the $510 donation from Team BN. The money given in this donation was raised from the Megaman Battle Network and Megaman Star Force Marathon hosted by Team BN at the end of 2013. Thank you to all of our donors for supporting us in such a great cause. In honor of this inconceivably hype race, we would like for the winner to decide where to put this money.
Yes.
So Caleb and Z-Wing, I don't know if you heard that, but thank you to Team BN who donated $510 to Winner's Choice.
I like it. 100%, yeah.
You got us paired up? You want to do a countdown?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, good luck, man.
Good luck.
And no, we are not using turbo controllers. These are official.
No turbo here.
Nope, no turbo. I got the good beat.
Yeah. Messed up my execution a little bit. That's alright.
There's a lot of game left.
There's a lot of game left.
Man, I can barely hear something. Turn this up. I love this intro stage, man. I'm tired of seeing it.
Alright, so pretty much what happened there, the bees can either shoot you or not shoot you. And if you touch the bees, just as is, they do a lot more damage. So the thing is, with this intro stage, is that you want to approach Vile, which is this last little bit here, with as little health as possible. Because what happens is, he doesn't actually hit you. Like normally, he'll punch you to death until your health is met, and then he'll stun you, just like what happened to Z-Link. That'll happen.
I believe 3 is the minimum?
Yeah, three is the maximum amount of health that you can have before you can have this cutscene happen. So, what happened there is, I actually got a little bit of bad luck, but that's alright. It's kind of, that's why it's called luck. Can't really do anything about it. Just gotta roll with it.
It's a marathon. You can't reset in a marathon.
Marathon look. So right now we're looking probably about a 7.5 second difference as of now. But there is a lot of luck in this run, so things can turn around pretty quickly. So we'll see. We'll see what happens from there.
Okay, so coming up here, I'm about to perform what's called a slope jump. Essentially, when you're running down a slope, you're moving at a much higher rate of speed. And that allows you to save a few frames, at least until you get the dash boots. Once you get dash boots, you really don't need to do some slope jumps.
You can only do a slope jump while you're walking down a slope.
Yes.
You can't dash.
Yeah, no dashing.
Or it won't work.
And I believe this is the only X game that you don't start off with the dash. So now that we got our mobility upgrade, things are going to get a little fast now.
So now the speed run actually begins. The dash is insanely helpful.
Yep. It's mainly why we go here first in the speedrun. Though normally in a casual playthrough you want to go here first anyways. Especially because we can't get the heart on the first visit, so we'll have to make a little trip later on. And now we're about to fight Ice Penguin. He's going to be sliding, that's all I know. And another thing...
And, yeah, this is one. This is the where the run can kind of turn around.
You want to explain Dash Lemon's odd doubles?
Oh, yeah.
Penguin is not playing nice today, man. And just right. Like that, Caleb's catching up.
Yeah, like we said, you know, there's a lot of luck involved. And no matter how well you play, it can turn around within one boss fight.
Yes.
And there's one boss fight in particular.
let's not go there, man. I'm already there. Come on.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Cyanaku, for the $50 donation. Woke up early just for this run. Go, Z-Wing. Beat that shirtless Adonis.
Go! And right now, you guys are going to notice we're not doing the same route. The route Caleb's using is approximately...
About 8.5
seconds faster than what I'll be using. But he's going to explain why I don't do it. Mr. Iceless.
Yeah.
Gotta swag it up, man. There you go.
This is something that a lot of my avid viewers know that I do. So, for some reason, these spikes won't damage you if you jump off of them while you're in the air. So it just looks like you're using a Game Genie or something like that, but it's just a minor glitch. It doesn't save time or do anything. It's just very, very funny.
If you want, after you take the first four Mavericks, that way it's consistent with your commentary. Okay. After that, we'll just make do.
This is a pretty hard jump up here. I'm going to explain it afterwards. God, dude.
Yeah.
All right.
Bullets too slow, man.
Ugh. All right. That jump that I just did to get that heart is really, really, really tough. It's called Iceless.
There you go.
What it is essentially you have 1.5 pixels on that wall to jump from to actually get in the range where you can grab the wedge. After you get in the range where you can grab the wedge, you only have about 2 frames to grab. So as you can see, it's really, really, really precise. I missed it quite a few times there, but needless to say, it's incredibly difficult. But no excuses. You know, it's a mistake.
I got a bad eagle. Like 6 dives. He's going to town.
But if you do get that jump first try, normally it's going to save about 8.5 seconds over Z-Wing's route. Because what he, a lot of the time that is saved with Iceless is actually on Mammoth stage, which is going to be the next stage that I'm going to do. Because you can actually use the boomerang. What? Oh my. Oh man. Alright. So, alright, I made another mistake there. This run's not really looking too good for me, but like I said, there's a lot of luck involved. It's pretty feasible that I might be able to pull through, but we'll see. Like I was saying, the boomerang can actually be used in Mammoth Stage to grab a couple items that is needed for the run. Granted, it's 100%, so you have to collect everything.
Yeah, as you've seen in mine, I went underneath the platform. He's not even going to go down there. He's going to just get right above it. Caleb 20 dives.
Yeah, but this is the boss I was talking about. You can dive a lot or be nice.
So about the same as me in terms of that play.
Alright, so that's average luck. Eagle likes to be a scumbag pretty much in general. And the dives are pretty much a huge time loss in 100% especially. Because I guess I forgot to explain. What you can actually do in this game, whenever you do a dash and then you shoot a normal buster shot, for some reason, it does 2 damage instead of 1. So you actually take advantage of that and use that against Eagle. Normally, what you would do in like a normal playthrough would be to use Chameleon Sting, because that's his weakness. But in this case, it's a little bit faster based on the route and everything else like that to use dash shots, because that's kind of all you have at that point.
Got it. I believe that was a stretch Surreal came up with. He's really good at routing a lot of games. And that strat's really cool. You have to do a little auto turn after you jump up there. So it's similar to Iceless in nature. Except you don't have to worry about getting
the
pixel perfect. You just stay on the platform. Okay, after Caleb's done with this Maverick, our routes are going to be exactly the same till the end.
Yeah, then we'll resume doing the same stages, but yeah, after these 4 Mavericks, like you said, we'll get back on track.
Thank you very much, Shader, for the $30 donation. Mom's been cancer-free for 10 years. Best of luck in the upcoming runs for a great cause.
So for this mini-boss, we have to hit it 8 times. We have to shoot 18 boomerangs, if they hit, whether they hit or not. After that, we finish them off with 5 lemons. which is the dash shot.
That's the common term you hear, lemon. It just means a regular shot. It looks like a lemon, hence we call it lemons.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Lemons.
I didn't get the toe.
And that's another thing. Like, there are a lot of bosses with, you know, luck involved. This is another one, so we'll see.
I'm about to do a trick called Waterless. It's how we get the heart before we go to Octopus stage. Oh. Come on. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna improv this.
Okay.
The farther down you get, the harder the trick becomes. I was not liking the. Look at that. Nice man. Now, the reason you really don't want to die in this category is we need 3 lives in order to get the Hadouken optimally. So a death will set you back not only, you know, from the obvious dying, but you have to farm for an extra life. That's why we get the use the boomerang to get the life in Chameleon stage.
Come on, man. Come on. That's just pathetic.
And that's why we use 18 boomerangs, so that the final hit, he'll always have 2 health left, and a dash shot will kill him. And another thing, during the stage intros and outros, we're always holding a button in. That speeds it up by a couple seconds, I think.
Yeah, I mean, holding start helps advance. You know, like this scene where it shows that you got the weapon and the password screen as well. And also text as well, so. Any text boxes that you do encounter, it's best to hold start. It's the fastest way to get through them.
Thank you, Guyver403, for the $50 donation. Shout out to the Mega Man X speedrun community, so many great runners and one I personally follow closely. Caleb and Zeering are the best at what they do in X1. Shout out to Akateru as well. Looking forward to Sneak's the best X4 runner in the world. Hopefully Zero. Show them what you are fighting for, X Buster and Z Saber Cancer.
We're coming up to a really cool stage, Spark Mandrill, and I don't know about you, but I've been listening to Smooth and Groove's a cappella this stage a lot.
Yeah, shout-outs to Smooth and Groove. Got some pretty dope a cappella action going.
Ah. Ah. Come on, come on. Two charge tornadoes and a single tornado will always take this guy out. There's really little RNG with that dude. Just the lag he can sometimes cause with the bubbles. But aside from that, you shouldn't have an issue with him. And like Stink Chameleon, this dude's weakness will really make him a lot simpler.
It's pretty much all about timing your shots so you can freeze them. You basically keep them in a stun lock.
Another thing, I don't know if we said it, but you, in this game, after every fight, you're always automatically forced to go to the center of the map. So if you can end the fight in the center, you'll save, you know, maybe a second or even a few frames, so it's worth it. And this is an important stage. It's Arm and Armadillo stage. You'll be seeing this a lot. But not until after we defeat Octopus. Because there's an important upgrade in here that we can't get yet.
Thank you very much, Tiki, for the $50 donation.
Tiki.
I love you, Tiki.
Thank you to the speedrunning community for putting on such successful and exciting marathons. I lost my dad to cancer 2 years ago, and as a speedrunner, these marathons mean so much to me. I wish I could be there racing with you guys. You guys are awesome.
No, you're awesome, Tiki. So, at the very end of this level, both of us use different lag reduction techniques. The way I do it is I go off the cart, and it's really preference, whatever you want to do, but you gotta make sure you at least see the health at the very top before you enter the door. Otherwise, it won't count as visit. Like right there, that's one visit. I have to do that 5 total times, but on the 5th time, I need to have every upgrade. Not too bad.
And what he's talking about with visits. So, for you Street Fighter people out there, there's an Easter egg in this game called a Hadouken.
Token.
Hadouken is incredibly broken in this game. And it's used in this 100% run primarily. One, because it's 100%. Therefore, you have to get it, so you don't actually complete the category if you don't obtain the Hadouken. And two, this one-shots every single boss in the game, except for Final Sigma. So it's incredibly useful. It actually reduces a lot of RNG in the later Sigma stages. So 100% is actually less luck-based than the other category, any percent. Because in the later Sigma stages, you have to fight all the boss fights just like normal. So you have to deal with all the RNG that you've dealt with previously. Not really sure yet. I'll have to take a look at the list.
Has Small Mario been met yet?
Ooh, yeah. Hey, let's go for Small Mario.
Small Mario, that's what I'm going to say for the rest of this race. Okay?
Yeah, Small Mario.
Well, let's meet it. So yeah, going off screen there eliminates a lot of lag, so it speeds up the animation so I can get the final heart. And you get to kill the snake just before he spawns. Once again, reduces lag. This is probably the laggiest stage in the game, correct?
It kind of depends, really. It's definitely one of them, I'd say. But yeah, this sub can cause a lot of lag.
Spinning. You can actually let him grab you so you can speed up the animation for his tornado, but there's I don't know why, but sometimes he'll just grab a hold of you and just instantly kill you.
Yeah, sometimes you can go for that strat and actually get, like, get punished. Ugh.
I couldn't just... Same as me. But he couldn't just wait a little bit longer before doing that?
Yeah.
So yeah, that
probably,
is...
Yeah, I probably could have prevented that if I was just playing a little more patient.
Fine. So yeah, we basically defeated every Maverick, and we gotta go take on Siggy. But we don't have 100% of the items, so we gotta go get it.
Thank you, the Completionist, for your $30 donation. What's up, dudes? This is the Completionist, showing some Megaman X love to Z-Wing and Caleb. You guys are the best. Keep on going.
Yeah, shout out to the Completionist.
Yep. So yeah, you're gonna see us die 3 times, but we're not doing that because we're bad. I mean, we are bad, but we're not that bad.
Yeah.
But it's required so that we can force visits as fast as possible.
Thank you, Evelyn Uni, for the $200 donation. Today I learned for the first time that my adopted mother is a cancer survivor. Nobody deserves to have to suffer any ordeal as awful as fighting cancer, but it's always tough when you learn someone close to you has had to suffer through it. A full bid goes to Zelda, a Link to the Past file name being named Cat. Love you, Mom. Hopefully this money can help someone else pick cancer's butt like you did. Thank you, Zacko, for the $30 donation. I'll toss in another $10 for each runner that makes the armadillo skip and each runner that Hadouken's Sting Chameleon. Here's hoping Caleb has a spare controller handy to destroy for when Rangda messes with him.
We're doing Aerodoke, man.
Yeah, definitely. That is... Yeah, that's gonna be a make or break, definitely.
Thank you very much, The Stove, for the $50 donation. Hey guys, thought you could use another 50 for the marathon.
We'll find out.
I lost my aunt and uncle a few years back to lung cancer and had to donate for a great cause.
Yeah, that's questionable.
Questionable. If it's not, then you're back in the game, man.
Yeah, like I said, we have to get these visits because you actually have to see this part of the screen 5 times in total.
Okay, this is the Hadouken. Mm-hmm. Essentially, you take out, like Caleb said, a lot of RNG in the Sigma stages. If you play any percent of this game, you guys know what we're talking about.
Thank you, KF Napa, for the $30 donation. I may not be able to match the $510 donation, but here's another $30 to winner's choice. Hope for a good race.
I'm gonna try a trick. It's called Leap of Faith, and we call it that because,
Guru is a Leap of Faith.
Yes. Ah. I didn't get it, man. So yeah, if you get that, it stays approximately 5 seconds because you don't have to wait for a cycle. But either way, I'm taking damage because we have to fight Bio again. And also, what I just did there was called Bio Text Skip. I don't think I got it. Nope. I missed the quick skip.
It's really not entirely too large of a time loss, though. Yeah, it's a minor sequence break. It actually prevents it. See, as you can see, like, a bunch of this stuff is happening. The game really doesn't even know what's going on at this point. Basically, that cutscene that just happened was supposed to happen in the previous room before I even entered that, you know, the boss door. Because basically what happens is the cutscene happens whenever you touch the ground. And as you can see there, we didn't touch the ground before we entered the boss door. So we actually bypassed that condition. Yeah, that was super close.
Yeah. We're also going to be, as you can see, we're going to be using the Hadouken on just about every fight, except, I want to say Rengda. He won't always cooperate, and you won't always be able to hit him with the Hadouken. And Charged Chameleon's your friend.
Mm-hmm. Got a love invincibility. Gwanger can actually give you insanely horrible RNG there.
I had that earlier in practice.
Oh yeah. He can teleport. Like I got really lucky there because he actually dashed towards me. That's kind of what you want. Because at that case, whenever you do fire off the Hadouken, it'll hit him as quickly as possible. But you can actually just teleport and make your day a living hell. Fortunately, it didn't happen.
This is one of the stages where a lot of RNG is taken away, because you fight two of the biggest RNG guys here. It's Ice Penguin and Storm Tornado, but Penguin has a cool AI for this, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you can consistently quick kill him.
He always starts out by shooting an ice shot, which that's his biggest mistake.
Oof.
And once again, turning invisible. Also, if you can manage to have the Hadouken connect while X is off screen, you'll save about a half second, I believe. I mean, it's
about a half second of excessive lag. It's just the hardware. That's more stuff it has to load.
Yeah,
and if you take that away, obviously it's going to be a little bit quicker.
Let's see what he gives me today. Come on. Oh. One. Oh. Ah! That's KO. That was a sort of okay fight. I don't like, the eye sometimes just goes out of your reach and...
Incoming 50 green eyes.
Nice.
That was pretty good.
Okay, so we're coming up... We're kind of going to do two of the biggest tricks in this entire run. These are the biggest time savers. This is one of them. I just skipped the Armadillo refight. But there's still one more fight I have to nail. And this is Sting Chameleon. Normally you can't hit him with the Hadouken, but we're going to try anyways. Ah. No! I didn't switch to ice, man. I feel like an idiot. Nice.
All right, so that obviously offset the race time a lot more.
Yeah, so this is
very
a little tight now.
Yeah, it made the race gap much tighter.
Yes.
So it's not over yet, boys. It's not over yet.
Okay, that's the best pattern you can get for Octopus. Otherwise, he'll stay in the air for a little bit longer. Dang, and he got it too.
Yep.
We only have one more Maverick to deal with, and he's not really that interesting.
Coming hardest boss fight in the game. Okay, good shot, man. Good job, team.
Come on, man.
Okay, I got it too. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Now, this next fight's a little... It has a few patterns, but we should be fine, right?
Should be.
I hope we are. Yes, got the best one. Yeah. Let's do this, man. Let's finish this.
All right. All right.
So we got two more Hadoukens left. I gotta show off.
I like to pop off shots.
There goes the dog.
Dog down.
Grip doggy. Oh. Okay, we cannot use the Hadouken on Velgarder Sigma, so we have to use his weakness, which is the bubble shield.
I mean, it always looks clutch, but it's pretty easy to get off.
I gave me a bad one, but that's fine. Time. That was interesting. That was interesting, man. You scared me when you got that air joking, man. I was like, dang, he's coming for me. So what was the time?
37:15.
Garbage.
Yeah.
An 8 of 36, man. Yeah, yeah. Not a 36.
We're really hoping to get 36s.
We all wanted a 36.
The current world record for that category is a 35:58.7 held by myself. It's actually the only 35 in the world as of now. And getting that run was insane. The amount of sanity that you have just to grind the luck and the execution and just breaking controllers and
eating pizzas.
Yeah. Speedrunning pizzas and that.
Pizzas.
It's a lot to deal with, but you just gotta keep in mind when you do reach that goal, when you do obtain that time that you are satisfied with, it's the best feeling in the world. And all I just wanna say is, for you people that feel like you can't get that time, but you have the execution and you don't feel like you can just go on any longer, keep going, because you will get it. And trust me, it's the best feeling you'll ever have, and there's nothing in comparison. So never, ever, ever give up. That's all I want to say.
Congratulations to Z-Wing, and of course both runners for putting on an awesome race. Very close.
Has Small Mori been met yet?
Let's see. Well, not yet.
Winner's choice, I guess, go to Small Moria.
A quick announcement. There has been a bit of a change in some of the incentives, or in some of the bid wars. Any percent warp run is now going to be 2K. Warp's run by Mitch is now going to be 2.5K, and Small Moyo is going to be 4K. This is just because people are having trouble donating at the moment.
I mean, I wish I missed a lot of stuff. Come on. You got that Aerodoke, and I missed it. I thought you were going to overtake me right there.
I want to give a very special thanks to this donation from Furke for $3,200. Yes, Furke, $3,200 donation.
Okay.
Hello, runners. First and foremost, thank you so much for all the hard work you're doing to support such a great cause. To show you, the PCF, and every person who has to deal with cancer, our support, my community, and myself collected this donation over the course of 3 streaming days. Keep up your awesome work, and I wish every runner the most of luck with their speedruns. So again, in the name of the whole German Furke community, thank you. I also put this towards Unity as the final name for Zelda Twilight Princess, because the only way to fight cancer is to work together for this great cause. You just watched a Megaman X.
We'll give one more flex. All right.
You just watched a Mega Man X race between Z-Wing and Caleb. Stay tuned for Mega Man X 3 by Z-Wing.
Woo! 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 So we got like 5 minute break or something?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Just a reminder, we are currently running a charity marathon for the...
Yeah.